you doing? Welcome to Phil's Notebook, page 203. Thank you for tuning into the show. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe our show. And once again, thank you for tuning in to Phil's Notebook. Snowy, how you doing today, girl? Yeah? Well, cool. That's really cool. By the way, I like the bandana. Very, very chic. Very chic. Yeah, I know you like to go shopping. I see it on my credit card all the time. Well, good. It looks good on you. It looks good. Anyways, you can tell spring is in the air right now. It's in full bloom. The other day I was walking through the park and I saw a robin giving a squirrel a lap dance. And and speaking of that, the town of Jupiter has been in the news a lot lately, and that's because of this Orchids of Asia deal. So for all you tourists out there heading to Jupiter, the town of Jupiter, that is, so just be careful. If you see a place called Jiffy Lube, it's not necessarily an auto repair shop. No. So be careful out there. Yeah. What? Well, I'm glad your name wasn't on the list either there, Snowy. So was I, actually. So anyways, let's get to our top 10 list. From the home office of Yeehaw Junction, Florida, top 10 unpleasant things to hear on an elevator. Top 10 unpleasant things to hear on an elevator. Elevator rides are interesting, are they not? Anyways, let's get to it. Here we go. Number 10. Does this look infected to you? Ew. Number 9. Hey, can you order a pizza through this phone? Number 8. Quickly, close the door. Joe Biden's coming. Anyways, number 7. Do you mind turning around? I have to pee. Number 6. Sorry about my finger. I was aiming for the button. Been there. Number 5. Hey, can I chew that gum when you're finished? Number 4. We're both going to the 19th floor. Want to make out? Number 3, I'm not just a Jehovah's Witness, I also sell insurance. Number 2, does it smell like pork rinds to you? And number 1, ignore the dog, we're gonna have him fixed soon. And there's your top 10 list. All right. Phone the neighbors, wake the kids. It is time to answer the You Suck Shoutouts, and you can send us an email or a You Suck Shoutout at philsnotebook@gmail.com. philsnotebook@gmail.com. And as always, if they weren't real emails, would I be able to do this? Not a chance in hell. There's no way that I'll be able to do that. Anyways, here we go. Email number 1. Hello, Phil. The sisters of the sorority house, Alpha Delta Pi, cordially invite you and Snowy to the end of the school year celebration. Brunch will be served at our house with tailgating at the stadium. You suck. Hope to see you there. Well, ladies, let's forget about the brunch, shall we, and just get right to the tailgating. Heyo! Yeah. All right. Enough of that. Okay. Jeez. Yeah, that one scared you too, huh, there, Snowy? Yeah. I know. All right, let's get the email number 2. What's up, Phil? Why is Snowy funnier than you? You really suck. And P.S., the Cubs are pond scum. Neil Thomas, Pompano Beach, Florida. Well, hold on, Neil. I don't think it's exactly fair to call the Cubs pond scum. As you can see on the chart that's coming up on your screen, you can see the comparison between the two of Cubs and pond scum. First of all, the Cubs emit CO2. Well, so does the pond scum. The Cubs occasionally very damp. Pond scum is also occasionally very damp. The Cubs consume microbes. Well, so does the pond scum. The Cubs failed to beat the Rockies in the 2018 wild card game. Well, the pond scum, well, they also failed to beat the Rockies in the 2018 wild card game. The Cubs, well, they're eligible for free agency after 5 years. The pond scum, and here's the difference, are not eligible for free agency after 5 years. The Cubs occasionally sponsor bobblehead night. Well, the pond scum, here's another difference, disdain flashy promotions. And of course, the last thing, the Cubs have one player named Rizzo. The pond scum, well, everybody's named Rizzo. And there's your comparison right there. So there you go, Neil. Okay, let's get to email number 3. Yo, Phil, why do you have a dumb dog on your show? The dog sucks more than you. Joe Sylvia, Boston, Massachusetts. Now, Joe, I don't appreciate you calling my dog and my band leader since the 1950s a dumb dog. Actually, she's a very smart dog. She's actually one of the smartest dogs in the world. And I will prove it to you. You ready? Snowy, you feeling good? Yeah? You ready? You comfortable? Here we go. 60 seconds on the clock. Ready? Let's go. Number 1, the only North American marsupial. Correct. Number 2, scientific name for the so-called northern lights. Correct. Number 3, stupidest member in Congress. Oh, wrong. The answer is AOC. Number 4, the three rivers that converge in Pittsburgh. Correct. Number 5, he's considered the father of modern day driving education. Correct. Number 6, the way Lady Gaga sings. Correct. Number 7, the son of the father of modern day driver's education. Correct. Number 8, what is the best way to get rid of the national debt? Correct. Number 9, which gas is formed when a hydrogen bomb is detonated? Correct. And number 10, in which sea battle was Mark Antony defeated by Octavian in 31 BC? Correct. All right, there you go. Proves it that she's the smartest dog in the world. Only on YouTube do I have the smartest dog in the entire world. But then again, I could be wrong. They call me Phil.